Hello, welcome to another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. I'm here at this, near the site of my lean-to that many of you have seen in my videos. And it was a great camp. I want to show you the power of Mother Nature. We had a mudslide in the creek upstream. Blocked off the creek, I'm guessing, and the creek washed through it and brought it on downstream. Now, my lean-to is back in the woods there, but I just come from upstream. And as near as I can tell, I think the lean-to is wiped out. I'm trying to find a place to cross a stream here. Right there is where my dog tried to cross. He got out there just a few feet and was floundering. He had to turn around and come back. Mud's really deep. Let's head on downstream, see if we can't find a place to cross. I think if we can find a place to cross, we can go up on the ridge, hike the ridge, and then drop down to the site of the lean-to. Let's go. You know, in spite of the harshness of nature, there is still beauty and bounty. Here is a lot of Indian potato, or Eskimo potato, wild potato. I think it's called sweet vetch also. Heady serum alpinum. Quite a lot of it. All right, let's continue on downstream. Now hopefully we can cross here where the creek narrows up and speeds up. Hopefully the mud won't be so widespread across the valley. And that is true, but unfortunately, still too difficult to get across without getting mud up to my knees. Let's continue on down. All right, there's where we just were, right up there. Okay. It's still narrow right here, but still, the mud's still too deep. Let's go on down to down in there and see if we can find something down in that area. All right, we just came from up there. Let's take a look here. I think right here looks like the best place to cross. We can see it is buck approved. My dog crossed right here. Crossed, came back, crossed again. So we're going to go ahead and make an attempt here. Hopefully we won't sink in too deep. This is a mess. I think we're going to make it all right, though. times like this where I really like a walking stick. Yeah. As you can see, okay, we're across here now. We're over on solid land. But that mud was up a good 5 feet. It must have been something pretty spectacular to see if a person had been here at the time it was coming down. All right, let's continue on. See if we can get up on the ridge. This Indian potato is everywhere around here. It likes riverbeds, stream beds, gravel. And also interspersed amongst it is this Canada buffalo berry, or soap berry, Schifferdia canadensis. It's very high in saponins and can be used as a soap, as you can see in a video I will list right here. It's also used by the natives traditionally as a dessert. They would add sugar to it and froth it with their hands. It froths up like a soap. And with the sugar and the frothing it up in a bowl, it'll end up being something like a whipped cream used as a dessert. All right, we're as far up the creek as we can go on this far side, because the ridge comes right down to the creek now, so we're gonna have to head up the ridge. So here we go. Okay, we're up on top of the ridge now. This old boy is out of shape. Anyway, as I said, amidst the destructiveness of nature, there's also nature's bounty and beauty. Right here is bunchberry, or dogwood is another name. Right here is wild rose with the rose hips. And as I showed earlier, the Schifferdia canadensis, the buffalo, and the Canada buffalo berry, soap berry. And over here is northern commandra, or timberberry. Okay, right over here is a pyrola. Right here, it's a wintergreen. Okay, it's not the kind of wintergreen that is used for flavoring. It's a different plant, also known as wintergreen. All right, we reached a point on the ridge here where we can head down to the lean-to. There's a game trail right here, headed down to the lean-to. So it's predominantly used by moose. Let's head on down and see what's left of the lean-to, if anything. Right past Buck, there is that log laying down. That's the valley floor, and I'm seeing mud. So it's not looking good. As you can see, there's lots of mud right there. Oh man, the lean-to is gone. It's It's many feet deep. We can't go down there on the valley floor like we used to. We'll side hill it and I'll show you what's left of the lean-to. Okay. This is where my lean-to sat. And there's pieces of it there. You can see my tarp. It looks like I just might be able to salvage the tarp. Okay. This is part of the roof poles that was shoved back by the mud. Right there where the fire pit was, it's under about 3 feet of mud probably. Over here you can see a string that I had used to tie my tarp up with. And since the tarp was up off the ground, covering the fire pit area, it just kind of laid over and just kind of washed down on top of the mud flow, and it never did go under. I was able to extract the tarp just fine by climbing out there on that log. And I've got it out. It's over here drying. I'll just let it dry and then I'll come back, pack it up, take it home, wash it out. Got a little muddy getting it out, but not too bad. Well, thanks for joining me and Buck. And we'll see you guys on the next video. You take care. Have a good one.